All right.
Sometimes you want as much space as possible for your painting. So what you can do is click on the actual browser part of Photopea and do command minus to shrink the tools, but not your painting. I still want to be able to see the layers, but I want a lot of space for painting. And I can stretch it. And then when I click on the actual canvas, then if I use command minus, it will shrink my image. So I'm still just trying to flesh this out. So for navigating your screen, if you go to Window in Photopea or Photoshop, you'll find a tool called the Navigator. And the Navigator is really helpful in digital painting. For one, without having to hold down spacebar or anything else, you can just click on it and move around, whether you're zoomed in or not. You can also use this slider to zoom in or zoom out without having to do command minus or command plus. But my biggest reason for encouraging you to turn on your navigator when you're doing digital painting is that no matter how zoomed in you are, it will show you what the whole thing looks like, right, as you're working on it. Just like sometimes when painters work, they keep a mirror with them so they can look at their painting in the mirror just to get some distance from it without having to walk 10 steps. So that is a good tool, and I want to see that what I'm doing here actually matters. What's trickier is seeing your reference at the same time. And professional software like Photoshop allows you to have multiple windows open that you can look at side by side. You can have multiple tabs, but I don't know that you can actually arrange them that way, so that the thing you're stealing color from or the reference you're looking at always stays in the same place no matter where you move around on your canvas. But there's a lot of different ways to set it up, which are helpful. You'll notice that I'm not going to use the eraser at all, even though I have extra stuff here that I don't need. Instead, I can always just paint it with the background color and kind of define it that way. So instead of erasing, just the answer is always more paint, layered up. I tend to say that a lot. And how this custom brush of mine is giving me that fur texture I want. And it has more to do with the brush settings here and the tip dynamics than with the actual shape of the brush. But customizing the shape of the brush is fun. Does matter a little bit. You just don't need any particular skill to make a brush. You just need to understand how those attributes work. So I really enjoy this phase of digital painting because I'm creating just such subtle variations of my palette that then I can steal from just over and over again. And each time I do, it layers them up a little differently and kind of works between them. And even though this isn't the overall finish I want, I'm going to get that from my refine paint layer. Taking time to get the base color and all the shadows and shapes kind of interesting makes my refined painting so much easier, which is done at about 50% opacity on top of this. So this is still all base color. This is all base color. My refined paint looks like this over the top. So I'm going to label that. And though you can stylize your painting any way you want, to make a digital painting, in my mind, for this class, you need to have learned these three techniques. So base color, different tonal values and transitions between your base color, and then a lower opacity refined layer of paint on top. Okay. And, you know, while the videos were processing going around, I was suggesting to many of you, you want to work with a bigger brush over a larger amount of area. That's because you still need to get to this stage where everything's filled in before you can start noodling around with individual hairs and individual shadows. Just like we did text blocking, you have to do kind of color blocking on your very first layer, whether it's on top of a linear sketch or not. And you can be pretty aggressive about it. Cover a lot of ground. Remember, our brushes are pressure sensitive, so the harder we press, the more they cover. And it depends how you paint, but in one way, the digital painting for me is faster than doing the same things with traditional paint. It's that holding down option and just stealing a color is a lot easier than cleaning my brush, mixing it on a palette to mix the new color. But I'm doing a lot of mixing just by layering them on top of each other at 70%. I guess I'm at, about 80%. I'll take that down a little bit. And then that soft edge of my custom brush is helping as well. But you can do a perfectly interesting, dynamic, personal, you know, well-refined digital painting, not ever using custom brushes. It's just always going to look very much like a digital painting. But if you want your digital painting to look more like watercolor or more like acrylic or more like colored pencil or more like pastel, it's just the edge of your brush that matters the most. And what kind of marks it makes. I think it's funny because if you put in to one of the text generation AIs, a prompt that says, I want a digital painting of, sometimes that will be like a cartoon, sometimes it will be photorealistic and airbrushed looking. There is no kind of one look of digital painting. It will just look like the computer tools at some point, right? And then the ambition of a lot of digital painting artists is that it looks indistinguishable, especially if you get a good print, from if I were to do this in acrylic paint or something else, which takes time to do. That would mean softening a lot of these edges, because I zoom in, and especially this base color still looks, you know, where you can see just hard edge pixels underneath, still doesn't look as refined as I need it to be to have finish over all of it. But this is the way you go about it. And we're not going to use compositing as part of this process today, but next class, when we're finishing it all off, we can kind of play with some special effects and features which really take advantage of all the tools digital art gives to us. And we can play with composites and texture overlays and just lots of different experiments with whatever digital painting we come with. But today it's all just hands-on making our pixels, mixing our colors to establish it. Not using the eraser. Instead, just adapting to what we put down. Okay, so I've got those feet. Big difference. I've got the back. Now where it gets a little harder to tell in the photo, photo reference is not perfect. I have to kind of understand the anatomy for myself, understand what the shadows would be doing, how the body might be turning. I like demonstrating with animals with fur because the fur itself kind of wraps around the form in the same way you can make your brush strokes wrap around the form. So that you're not just putting color down, you're also kind of restating the shape of the animal each time you choose a direction to paint. All these individual strokes are following the fur. And I'm needing to go less and less to some of my color references to steel color because I can just go to my my own parts of the painting. I've already established a lot of it. Then you have the cat's tail, finishing off the foot. Anything you kind of ignore and don't finish off in your base color layer just means it's going to be more work for you later. So I want to get kind of those deeper shadows that are in the feet at least acknowledged. That's why we do animals from head to toe, so you have to pay attention to these different aspects. For a portrait, the areas that we often kind of ignore and don't work on enough are things like the hair, the ears, the neck, the shoulders, because we're so captivated by the eyes and the nose, the forehead, the mouth. So part of digital painting can be part of the annoyance of it, is trying to touch every part of it and bring it to a relative finish. That's satisfying. And then when your strokes are so disparate and you have trouble like selecting a color, that's where your palette comes in up here. At any time, you can save a color off to the side to use later. You can make this palette as messy as you like because it'll all get erased in your final. And then if any time you